Nothing beats a good steaming plate of OJ after a long day at the business factory. Am I right, fellas? Good, wholesome, family-friendly, sitting around whistling Blue Moon of Kentucky orange juice. But how is it really made? Well, today I'll be leading you through the life and death of orange juice. So people actually didn't even really drink orange juice before the 50s because OJ is like the perfect breeding ground for bacteria. I mean, they use it to make Pruno in prison, if that tells you something. So because of its high sugar content and basically non-existent shelf life, if you weren't making orange juice yourself, you weren't getting it. Also, due to the hundreds of years of forced inbreeding by humans, all citrus trees are almost entirely infertile. So orange is born on life support and never gets off. So a farmer has to babysit an orange for years, just in the hopes of it giving off fruit. And if there's one thing that oranges love more than fighting scurvy, it is dying. Whether it gets too hot, dead. Whether it gets too cold, dead. Too much rain, dead. Too little rain, dead. Nothing happens, still dead. So if by some miracle the fruit doesn't die, it's picked and sent off to the factory. So the oranges show up at the factory in these repurposed dump trucks where they get washed off and sent down the line. So the ugly ones get thrown into the shame pile, but the beautiful ones get beat to death. That's where we get the juice. Now it's at this point that the orange has to decide, does it want to go to school and get a degree to become pasteurized orange juice, or go ahead and go into the workforce and start a family as frozen orange juice? Now whenever they created the process to make orange juice that didn't kill most people, they found that the juice sucked. This is because the juice would have to be pasteurized and then potentially spend months in these huge tanks devoid of air, or as these comically oversized orange cubes in storage. So when it did come out, it just tasted like nothing. Just drinking the void. So to combat this, scientists created something called a flavor pack. What is a flavor pack, you may ask? Well, it's a combination of citrus acid and other orangey stuff that gets taken out of orange peels and then swirled back into the juice to make the tongue happy again. These things are unsurprisingly very controversial. They're not listed on the ingredients, they're not considered artificial flavors, and the companies hate talking about them. Are they actually bad? No, not really. People use orange zest all the time in cooking. It's not that big of a deal. In fact, I think that most of these companies' problems would be solved if they were just a little bit more open about the flavor pack. I mean, come on, your cousin Jimmy eats bananas with the peel on, okay? So with that being said, the juice is boxed and loaded up for transport on the juice train.
No white refrigerated car. The only regularly scheduled juice train is through the district. It ensures
no lie, I am not going to sit here and just say that the juice train is not the coolest thing that will ever exist. 100 ton train cars just carrying juice. Nothing else. Nothing else. Just juice. Juice train. What parts of the orange doesn't get used in the flavor packs or the orange juice actually gets ground up and sold as feed to cattle farmers. Milk really does grow on trees. From the juice train, the product is distributed out to the various grocery stores, and from there, to your refrigerator. So the next time you're cracking open an orangey one with the boys, just think, this thing could kill me if it wanted to. I give orange juice 7 out of 10.